By knowing more about what our crops are doing out in the field and actually being able to assign numbers to specific plant traits, we can then start to make breeding decisions and management decisions based upon that new information, which really wasn't possible before we had these drones and cool sensor technologies that we're now able to deliver for the Australian Plant Phenomics Network.
Phenotyping is really just describing the physical nature of living things. My phenotype is tall, grey-haired, fit and healthy. I'm Trevor Garnett. I'm the National Field Phenomics Director at the Australian Plant Phenomics Network. We've got a range of field and controlled environment facilities around the country, and I manage the Field Phenomics Program. We've been phenotyping plants for years, just measuring yield on a wheat plant, and the height of a wheat plant is phenotyping. But modern phenomics is using new sensors, robotics, and enhanced computing abilities to be able to better describe plants and their performance.
I'm Dr. William Salter. I'm a lecturer in crop physiology based at the University of Sydney. I've also just taken over the directorship of the University of Sydney node of the Australian Plant Phenomics Network based up in northern New South Wales. Phenotyping is the process of measuring properties of plants, and I guess phenomics is the process of taking that further and using new technologies to collect really large data sets on plant properties that we wouldn't have otherwise been able to dig into. GRDC invests in multi-environment trials in a lot of its investments in terms of research. Having six field nodes of the APPN based across the country allows us to apply the same phenotyping tools to those trials, regardless of whether they're over here in the east in New South Wales, down in the south near Adelaide, or over in the west in Western Australia. So we could fly the same drone with the same hyperspectral sensor, with the same LiDAR sensor, with the same data analytic pipelines to really provide that Australia-wide knowledge about how our crops will perform across these different environments. Both of the trials that we flew our drones over today were from GRDC heat tolerance investments, which really seek to improve the intrinsic heat tolerance of our grain crops in Australia. So we are looking at whether these crops can yield under high temperatures that are sown later in the season. And what we're doing with our drone data is just adding extra information so that our breeders can decide whether a pre-breeding line is heat tolerant or not heat tolerant. And we want the heat tolerant.
We're at CIRD's Turret Field Research Centre, and we've got a ground-based phenotyping platform. This platform has been developed by the plant accelerator team at the University of Adelaide. It's an Omega robotic platform, and the plant accelerator team have added digital cameras, a hyperspectral sensor, and a LiDAR sensor. The hyperspectral sensor measures the reflectance of sunlight off the leaf of the plants, and it can tell you a lot about the plant itself. So its health, its water content, its nutrition status, and disease status. Net blotches lead to major yield losses in barley. Each year, approximately $125 million is lost due to net blotches. What we're seeing today is part of a strategy by GRDC to produce barley varieties with much higher resistance to net blotches. The better we can describe crop performance, the easier we can identify traits that lead to high yielding crop varieties, and the easier we'll be able to identify management practices that will lead to higher yields.
Our field nodes are providing state-of-the-art phenomics tools and data support that allow us to go from fairly simple traits that we've been able to measure in the past and really give us a huge amount more depth of understanding into the plant phenotype. And then we can link that to the plant genotype and make decisions about how we breed future varieties.
With the Australian Plant Phenomics Facility that was founded in 2008, which is the precursor of the Australian Plant Phenomics Network, Australia led the way in phenomics research. We're again leading the way with the world's most comprehensive, truly national network of phenomics capabilities and phenomics experts.